You don't have to be alone again. Could I take you by the hand and never go? Would I tell you that I love you?
What's going on? Today we're going to be reviewing Khalid's new song, Right Back, featuring A Boogie with the Hoodie. Before we start, I'm going to give you guys an insight into who these artists are. A Boogie with the Hoodie is a 23-year-old rapper who was born in the Bronx, New York, legally as artist Julius DeBose. We're not going to get too deep into his life because he plays a minimal role in the song. Although personally, I really like his verse. He does not contribute much to the song. He has one verse and the rest of it is Khalid. So without further ado, let's jump into Khalid's life. Khalid was born February 11th, 1998 into a military family in Fort Stewart, Georgia. As most military families do, he spent most of his childhood moving around from place to place. He inhabited places like New York, Germany, other places like that, all while he was moving with his father, mother, and the rest of his family. Before he finally inhabited El Paso, Texas, where he created his debut song, Location. It was a hit. Everybody loved it. He was on the rise from there. There was no stopping him. I actually recently did a study at our school, Wiregrass, on about 100 students. You know, I was walking around randomly with the clipboard and then, you know, minimize confounding variables from, like, if I ask certain people because then they'll be biased. But that's besides the point. So when I asked 100 people, 88% of them said they like Khalid's music and they'll listen to him. 6% said they have never heard of him, which is the surprise to me. I mean, I thought everyone heard of him. But the remaining 6% said they don't even listen to his music at all. They've heard of him, but either just because it's not their style of music or they don't like his music, they do not listen to him. Through the small sample study I conducted, you can see he's a very well-respected artist. He's well-known.
The beat is cold. It's giving me a good vibe. I actually really like this. This thing goes hard.
Watch, not a Richard. It's a million plus three reasons I lied. I could admit it. And I just don't want you to waste my time.
Cause I'm trying to get with you. I be feeling down, but I'm fine when I'm with you. You be thinking I be lying when I say I miss you, girl.
Okay,
you
just on your body like a tissue.
They be calling you a Illuminati when I'm with you. I say maybe it's your third eye, I love your music. BBS is on me, look like now. Let us look you up, but you never go back to the guy that was.
They do not release just to release. All of their music is good. From when they started to this very day, to this very minute, everything.
The first verse is done by A Boogie with the Hoodie, and it seems to feature a lot of literary devices. One example would be hyperbole. So, in the first few lines, Khalid
Boogie says,
there's a million plus three reasons I lied. Obviously, there's not a million and three reasons he lied, but it adds to the effect of why he did what he did. You know, if he were to say, like, there's a few, it would, like, be less of a reason why he did it, and it wouldn't be as much as an excuse as it is when he says a million. A million makes it seem like, you know, it was like he had to do it, like he couldn't resist, or, whereas just saying one or two just doesn't give it that same effect. Another literary device Boogie uses in his verse is allusion. He refers to this mystery woman as the Illuminati. Now, the Illuminati is an organization where, what we believe, trying to reform the world and, like, brainwash people and everything else to make the world better, as they call it. That's not my word. I'm just repeating what I've heard about the Illuminati. I don't believe in it, per se, but, yeah. So the illusion then gives us the feeling that this mystery woman, you know, obviously she's not trying to reform the world, but maybe what he's saying is that he is going to be changed by her, and she has the, of course, she has the ability to change how he feels, how he thinks, how he acts, because he really wants to be with her. So he will do anything that she wants from him, basically like the brainwashing that the Illuminati does in real life, if they're a real thing. I have no idea, but yeah. Also during this verse, Boogie uses concrete diction, which is basically the words used to describe physical conditions or qualities. And Boogie does this in, he uses this in saying he's on her body like a tissue. Also by saying he wants to get with her. Another example of when he's using concrete diction. VVS is on me. Look like now and laters. Lick you up, blah, blah, blah. Anyways, VVS is on me is like him saying all of his jewelry, necklaces, rings, whatever it may be, is VVS is diamond standard. It's very, very slight. So the cuts and everything else, it's like an almost perfect diamond, basically. Just like a level below perfect. And lastly, he uses it again when he says, baby, you know you take hours when you get dressed up. Whatever he says it something around those lines. That's concrete diction. So the reason I'm going over the concrete diction he uses is because the concrete diction builds up the seriousness, in a sense. It builds up the actual emotion he feels. It lets us as listeners know what he actually feels and that he's passionate about it. Also, as listeners, concrete diction is really important in songs, because if it wasn't so concrete, it'd be a lot more room for interpretation, which in turn makes the song less recognizable, less, it just like takes out the validity, in a sense. It makes you not feel the song on a spiritual note as much, or on a mental, physical note as much. Boogie does an amazing job making a transition for Khalid to be able to come in and do verse two, his first verse in the song, by using the words, baby, you know you can do whatever you got, and then leaving the rest of that sentence blank. Khalid comes in and finishes that sentence off saying power. Now it actually flows together really smoothly, which isn't something you see every day. It's because it's really smooth, you know, it's like the same person was going through, but it's not the same person. It's two different people coming together, working together. Just as Boogie does, Khalid uses a multitude of literary devices throughout the song. During verse 2, the first one we notice him using is a hyperbole. The hyperbole comes in when Khalid says something along the lines of, got me waiting by my phone for hours. Basically, the hyperbole comes in. He hasn't been waiting for hours for a text or call or whatever, but he's been waiting. And this hyperbole, as a Boogie uses a hyperbole too, creates more effect. It shows more emotion. It shows more of a meaning to the song. It shows more of a meaning to the person. Basically, Khalid has been waiting for this mystery woman to text or call him, whatever it may be. He has been waiting for what he calls hours, which has probably been maybe minutes or whatever. But he exaggerates the time to show that he has been waiting for a while.
It shows how desperately he's been waiting for this call.
So through listening to this song, we kind of get the feeling that we have a positive tone shown throughout the song. So an example of positive tone used by Boogie is that he says, I be feeling down, but I'm fine when I'm with you. The mystery woman makes him feel better. She's kind of like an antidepressant. And although antidepressant and sadness are associated with the negative connotation, basically, the song is more uplifting than it is negative. Especially like even in the beat, you know, the beat is like one of the major components of a song that can tell you what the tone is. You know, the beat can tell you if it's neutral, if it's positive, or if it's negative. A negative beat is usually going to be like, you know, more, I don't know, more bass, like, I don't know, there's going to be a lot of drums and stuff like that, a lot of more loud or less positively connotated sounds. You know, this song has like a more melodic flow than the background. The track has a melodic flow, and it's a lot more calm, peaceful. It's uplifting, which is why we draw the conclusion that it's positive. Khalid does not... So the positive tone is shown by Khalid when he starts bringing up the mystery woman as well. The mystery woman is basically not completely what the song is based on, but the mystery woman is, you know, she represents a good portion of it. So when Khalid speaks on the mystery woman, this is also him being happy, being with her. Although they're not dating, he'd love to be dating. Let's take things slow is what he says. You know, let's just bring it right back. You know, let's just be together, have fun, just chill. So Khalid gives us a chill vibe, which gets positively connotated. Yeah, so the chill vibe, you know, bring it right back. And even in the music video, it's another way to see the tone of the song. You know, if there's a lot of deaths or shootings or head down, things like that, obviously it's going to be a more negative connotation. And then when in the song, when everybody's dancing, having a good time, you know, everyone's talking, drinking, like, you know, just juice or whatever, talking, dancing, yeah, drinking, just having a good time. It's like a party. It is a party. They're having a party, a barbecue. You know, almost always a barbecue is not going to be negative. It's going to be positively connotated. Therefore, we can conclude that Right Back has a positive tone. Khalid has a positive tone. A Boogie has a positive tone. This song represents love, happiness, and affection in a way we just don't see anymore. You know, these two artists are very genuine. Everything they do in this music video is for the music. You know, it's not for fame, it's not for something else. It's everything they believe in and everything they stand for. You know, you don't see this kind of music anymore. Nowadays, mostly like the rap or hip hop, R&B, whatever it is, it's always, you know, it's always referring to drugs or weapons or sexual activities, things like that constantly. And in this song, we do get one drug reference, but you know, it's not like a you should do this, it's just like a, you know, it fit in the rhyme, it fit, like the syntax allowed for it, so it was something that was not such a big deal to be in. But another song that's more like the song is solely about the drugs, the weapons, you know, all that kind of stuff. But in this song, it's more about love, happiness, affection. So that's just something we don't see anymore. Music and music videos nowadays are a lot less pure than they once were or ever have been. So this is just like a nice little reminder of, hey, you can make great music, you can make a great video without referring to drugs, weapons, and sexual activities. So that just makes the song so much better than, you know, the other songs that are going around nowadays, you know, than the other music videos that are circulating through the internet right now. You know, a lot of people like the song. I love the song. A lot of other people like it too, you know. And I think most of the reason is because of how pure it is, how nice it is. And it's just a great song overall. The vibes are amazing. Tone is amazing. Everything about it is good. So people tend to gravitate towards positively connotated things. And this being positively connotated, people tend to gravitate towards it.